Hello again and welcome to another video from the Marketing Study Guide. In this video, we're going to have a look at how we make the BCG matrix using Excel 365. My name is Jeff and I'm a long-time marketing lecturer and practitioner. Now, we're going to end up making this BCG matrix, as you are probably trying to do with the quadrants and portfolios mapped on it. So let's jump into Excel and see how it's done. Okay, I'm now in Excel and I've just listed the steps that we're going to work through and I've got them there for reference. So step one is we set up our data. I've already done that. It's at the top. And what we need is something like this, where we have our firm or our business unit we're going to have listed. I've got letters there, ABC. You would have names. And then for each one of those, we need to have the market share. So that's going to be important, and the market share of the largest competitor. And what we do is we divide that formula there, C divided by D. So we divide the market share of the portfolio by its largest competitor to get relative market share. Okay, so you can see I've got rectangles here, A, B, C, and then another rectangle for the next three, and then two more. What I've done is these are from the same industry and they're in the same market. That's why they've got the same growth rate. And these three are from the same and these are from the same. Just to show you how it works, you don't have to match them in the BCG to the same industry, but just for the sake of this example. So what you'll see is the largest player then goes to say, okay, what is the market share of the next largest? Okay, so that's 30%. That 30% comes up here. And everybody else in the industry is mapped back or compared back to the market leader. So that 40 comes here. D is the market leader in their market, so they become the reference point and they refer directly to the second player. So that's how it works. So what you'll see in every market, if you're mapping a market, there's only one player that will have a relative market share greater than one, and that's our market leader. Everybody else will be less than one because that's the way the BCG matrix has been designed. I have another video about whether we should change that for modern day, so please check that out or check out the articles on the website with the link below. So I've colored that because that's going to be our horizontal or our x-axis. Then we need to have the market growth rate. Now you might have these percentages already, but if you don't, we're just simply going to compare sales last year to sales this year. Notice it's unit sales. It's unit sales here or unit share here. Again, the BCG matrix was constructed thinking about the economies of scale and experience curve benefits, and cash cows and stars had a greater capacity to get their cost structure down by having higher unit production. If you want to, you could use revenue shares and revenue growth here if you think that is more appropriate for your market that you're looking at. Obviously, market growth rate is just a change in sales over the year. So G over F minus one expressed as a decimal or a percentage. And as you can see, we can have negative growth rates. So we could have a market in decline. That's fine. That'll just become a cash cow or a dog. And this one here, I've got the unit sales for each portfolio. I'm using that to construct circle sizes. So this one here has 4 million unit sales is going to be the largest circle. This one here is going to be the smallest one. If I were to use these numbers to create circles, I would actually have G as the largest circle, which doesn't make sense given its overall size. So I'm trying to express magnitude. Then we need to insert a bubble chart. So I'm just going to come down here, go up to insert, going to click on that icon and click on that. And I get a blank chart, which is fine, which is what I was expecting. Just moving that down. Now, step three is select data. So you can see I've got the chart menu up. If I click off it, it disappears. To get it back, I just click on it again and I go to chart design, select data, and I want to add. And the series name is whatever I'm going to call the chart. I'm just going to call that example. Then the X values is relative market share because that runs along the bottom. The Y values is the percentage growth rate, runs up and down. And then I'm using the bubble sizes as is. Don't worry about the size of the numbers because they're all relative. And Excel will adjust, and then I hit OK. And I have something initially that looks like that. Okay, I've just moved my webcam up the top so we can see what's going to happen next. Next, we're going to add data labels. I don't need to bring up the plus button. So I click on the chart, I get the plus button, I come across to data labels, I go to more options. What I want to do is click value from cells and take, and for that, I want the value or the name. So it's going to ask me where I'm getting it from, and I want the name of the business or the firm or the SBU you're using. And I want to make sure that nothing else is clicked, and I want it to be centered. So if I click off that, if I just close that out, you can see now I have the names in the middle. Okay, so that's good. Then I want to reverse the relative market share. In the BCG matrix, this side has the stars and the cash cows. So that is the higher number of relative market share. So I need to reverse that order. Pretty much we, again, bring up the plus button, go across to axis, more options. And I have this menu coming up which says format the axis. And I come down and just click values in reverse order. Okay, and that's happening. Again, I'll close that down. Then I've got all these grid lines. I don't want those. Bring up the menu again. Take grid lines off. We're getting there. Now I need the axis to be in the middle. As you know, the BCG matrix is a matrix, so it's got quadrants. It's not a normal chart. So I need to move these lines across so it makes sense. So what I'm going to do, again, is going to axis, more options. This time I'm going to look for the vertical axis. Where is it going to cross? And for this one, it's going to be, you won't be able to see it, but I'm putting 1.0 in. So now it's crossing at a relative market share of 1. Now you can change that. You can make that a bit lower if that makes sense to you, depending on the market you're looking at. Okay, I've also got these numbers running up and down and I don't want them, so I'm going to change that. So again, go back into axis, or you can do it at the same time. And then down the bottom, I've got display units, none, which is good. Then I come down to tick marks. I want none and none, which is good. And labels, it says label position. And again, I want no labels. So what I have is a straight line across. The BCG matrix is more of a visual medium rather than a numerical medium. You could leave the numbers in if you wanted to, but typically we see them presented, the chart presented without that. And then we repeat that. I go for each one. Again, I just go back in, or we could again do it at the same time. And this time I'm going to change not the horizontal, which it comes up automatically. I'm going to make it the vertical. I'm going to repeat the process, except this time I want the axis labels to cut at 10%. So 0.1 I'm going to put in, you can't quite see it, but I'm putting 0.1 there, and you can see it jumps up to the 10% mark. Again, I've got these scores here, I don't want them. So to get rid of them on the vertical, we do the same thing. Go in, axis, more options. Remember, it goes straight to the horizontal. I want to change it to the vertical. I've already changed the axis value just then. Make sure tick marks are set to none. Labels are set to none. And label position, none. So all of these down the bottom should be none. And we have something like that. So we're getting there. Next, I want to add the text boxes because I want to show that this is the stars. So what I do is I click on the chart. Very important that we do that. And I insert a symbol or a shape. I'm just going to put in a box. Going to put a box there. I want it to be empty, so no fill. I'll leave it with a blue background. And then the formula box, I want to put a formula. So I've got the equal sign, I've got clicked on the box, equal sign, and I've got the word star here already. And I just click on that, and it gives me stars there. And I'm just going to center that, and you can move that around wherever you want. And then the reason you need to click on the chart is it'll stay connected to the chart. If you don't click on it and put it over the top, Excel thinks it's a separate piece of information and it won't be connected. Then I simply copy that box, copy it, and then I'm going to paste it here. Paste it again. I'm going to put four boxes here. And paste one more time. And then what I would do for each one, this one here, I would then delete it. Again, go to equals. And then come down to this time question marks. That's going to run over the lines. I'm just going to expand that. And then we simply repeat that as required for each of the others. And then if you wanted to, you can format colors. So for example, if you wanted, I had B looking a bit different. I click on it, I go to format, and then just make it a different color. That might be our company, so it stands out. And then I just repeat that for both. So this should be our final BCG matrix if you follow those instructions. There's also a link below to a free template for Excel to make it without you having to do it, whatever's easy for you. And please check out my other videos and please subscribe to the channel.